Hi, I'm Orno Solomon. I'm the founder of Mont Pèlerin, with the French accent. And I'm actually really looking forward to meeting you at the Swiss Finance and Technology Association. Yeah, hi, I'm Arnaud Salomon. I'm the CEO and founder of a company in Geneva called Mont Pèlerin. We started as well another company called Ibany. So now we have like two companies in Geneva. So Mont Pèlerin is a project in Geneva to create a new bank, a new type of bank, obviously, which is based on three fundamental pillars: full reserve, marketplace, and tokenized. So to make it quick, full reserve, I guess everybody understands, we want to be a very, very low risk type of bank where we don't loan out people's funds that are deposited within the bank. We don't play with it, we don't gamble it. It means that we are safe from the perspective of a bankrupt. Now, how do we make money as a bank if we don't do on-balance sheet credit? And that's the second point, marketplaces. We believe that as a banking institution, we shouldn't be the sole counterparty for each and every product and services you might want to consume. Therefore, we act more as a brokerage platform where we aggregate all the offers of the market, whether it's coming from UBS, Cantonal Bank, or even Lending Club, into a single platform for you to consume what fits you best. And of course, the third aspect, which is the most interesting one, we believe, is to bring the entire bank on-chain, to tokenize the entire balance sheet, the people's deposit, the euro, the dollar, the Swiss franc, as well as all the banking assets. Because at the end of the day, banking assets are contracts. And what we do is basically to code basic functions of such contracts into a smart contract to automate its life cycle. Yeah, I mean, if you look at it, a loan is a contractual agreement that you have with the bank. This can be really automated in the form of smart contracts and basically being able to own such assets in the form of fraction of 5 francs to pretty much anyone. Yeah, I mean, we've seen a lot of exuberance in this in the crypto market, in the blockchain market in general. We've seen a lot of entrepreneurs getting there, not necessarily for the good reason, not because they wanted to change the world or not because they really believed in what they were doing, but simply because they thought that it was easy money to raise. The bear market that we lived in the past months was actually a good one because it really wiped out all those bad actors, not all, but I mean a lot of them, and the entire industry is now refocusing on bringing value to people, on bringing added value, and I believe that that's actually a good thing that it happened. So if you look at it, ICOs were quite interesting. Yeah, I mean, a company could issue a token, and especially utility token, and sell it directly to its own crowd to raise money. At the end of the day, we saw a lot of confusion. You know, some projects were great and they were like really bringing some tokens that were adding value to their own project, and some others were just creating a kind of just a token on top just to raise money without really focusing on what is the utility of it, how people are going to use it, does it really make sense. So now we saw the industry shifting into the STO type of world, which is very interesting because now we have something more where we share, let's say, economical value with the investors, with the token holders, such as like profit sharing and things like this. But it was always structured in the form of a private contractual agreement. And therefore, if you read carefully those contracts, yes, they will promise to share with you 20% of the future dividends or revenue or whatever. They would grant you some rights, etc. But because it's a private contractual agreement, and if you read it carefully, most of those projects were adding some little lines in this contract saying that potentially they could change the nature of such a contract. And as an investor, as a token holder, you're not that much protected. You're only protected basically by the goodwill of the issuer of such tokens. And what we did last year was quite historical because for the very first time, we incorporated the share of a company into a token and make it one thing. And therefore the token holder is a shareholder. And he has now all the traditional rights that comes along with it, the economical rights, the dividends, and social rights, voting. And now the token holder is protected by Swiss law and not only by your private contractual agreement. And this is a huge step forward, because if you look at it, now that the company can be tokenized, like the shares of the company can be tokenized, you can address pretty much anyone. You can address VCs, because I mean, at the end of the day, they know what they buy shares. It doesn't change anything for them. You can address the crowd directly that can own a piece of your company, and therefore you can address ambassadors, you know, not only contributors, but people are, that are investing in your company. They truly believe in what you do, and therefore they go back in their family and friends and they share the word, and they actually, it really creates a very good dynamic, yeah? And we believe this is the way forward today. Yeah, so Mont Pèlerin obviously is a very ambitious project. We are building a bank. The banking license is something that obviously takes a lot of time, especially because we are really shifting the way we want to conduct the business, the banking business. Again, we're not a crypto bank, and we're really bringing the legacy bank on chain. But yet, we still have to actually show and prove to the regulator that it works. We have to prove that the core banking system that we have developed in-house is robust, secure, and that it works as expected, and within the standard of what is expected from a Swiss banking institution, etc., etc. So we expect now to be live in about a year, in about a year time. Of course, this is approximative, but we are in a good track now. Yeah, for us, it's crucial. Of course, we are Swiss, so it makes sense for us to be in Switzerland. But we also believe that Switzerland is the kind of safe haven for the world in terms of security, in terms of pretty much everything. If you look at it, Switzerland is the only country in the world that has never ever confiscated its citizens over its entire lifetime. If you look at history, France, Germany, US, at some point in time in their history, they confiscated either the gold of the people, they confiscated money, they devalued massively currency, etc., etc. Switzerland is a very decentralized country, and we believe this is great. And also, we have politicians that are not our masters, they are our servant. Yeah? They execute the will of the people. If you look at it in France or in other democracy, people, they don't vote for laws, they elect kings. Yeah, so I mean, I call them kings, obviously they call themselves presidents, but it's pretty much the same in terms of power. We truly believe that Switzerland is a model to follow, and especially in such an industry as blockchain that actually wants to actually bring back the power to the people, Switzerland makes totally sense for us to be in. If you look at it, all early stage startup, they need pretty much the same thing. They want to get in touch with the ecosystem. They need visibility. They need help to meet potential investors as well as partners, etc. So, I mean, the association is great because it really brings all those people together, and it creates opportunities for the entrepreneurs to actually pitch what they do, of course, but not only, you know, like make potentially a good partnership, you know, things that make sense because like people are complementary, etc., etc., as well as probably even growing the team, because when you are an entrepreneur, most of the time when you start, you're like one or two people, and you need to grow, you need hands, you need people to be hands-on, and you need to have people that share the same vision. So actually it's great when you actually when you are able to actually be part of an ecosystem, when you can share ideas and when you have an impact, people joining you. So yeah, so in the path of becoming a Swiss bank, obviously, we don't want to just wait and work only on the background. We have a product actually that we wanted to release to the entire world for free, obviously, because what we do is always open source. And it's a tokenization platform, because if you look at it today, there are too many people that actually believe that they could sell, I will issue a token for you and you will pay me 50K for that. I mean, we believe this is not the right way. We believe that tech should become a commodity. It should be something that is open source, that people can use freely. So what we have developed is something called the Bridge Protocol, which is a kind of middleware, the decentralized finance middleware that lives on top of Ethereum, on the public Ethereum, that is able to actually restrict the transferability of security tokens based on the rule engine. And this is extremely powerful, and we created a front end for that, so that anyone can actually go onto the website, fill up the name of their company, the amount of shares, the price, if they want to create some sale event, so they would create the sale and say, starts this date and this day, this is the private one, the public one, this price, etc. And at the end, they would plug the Trezor or any hardware wallet, click on generate, validate on the hardware wallet, and it would deploy the set of smart contracts for them. And all that completely for free, of course, and they can do it on their own within 5 minutes. And of course, this is only the tech side, because when you want to do such thing, you have to obviously tackle the legal aspect. We can help also, I mean, like presenting and introducing to the relevant people, but at least the tech side should become free for anyone to use, and we want to build basically a standard for the Swiss financial ecosystem.